This is Charisma Pedole in the 336 Northwest. I see the two red UFOs of Andromeda far away from the moon to the right in the bottom. I took some pictures of them and they are very clear now. They are very clear. It is June 22nd. It is close to 3 a.m. some minutes before 3 a.m. And as I said, I was in the 336 degrees northwest. The two UFOs, the red ones from Andromeda, are in the lower right side of the moon. So I am trying not to move too much the phone. And you can see them easily. I see them very clearly. And, well, I don't know if I am getting the moon because I am following the UFOs. They are too low from the moon, though. But it looks like the camera will get them because there is a lot of light of the moon. And I'm following them. Let's see if I can make it. Well, I lost the moon now. Oh, there's the moon. Okay. But I see the UFO. I see one now. Let's see the other one. It looks very shiny red. One of them. It shines more like if they put more light. Hi, Andromedans. This is Charisma Pedole in New York. And it's the 22nd of June of the 2016. And I even see another third UFO, but it's not red. It doesn't look that red. It looks blue. Wow. So, well, let's see when I see the video. That is the subway, because the bluish could be orbs, or it could be the Arcturian UFO. So let's see when I see the video what happens. Well, thank you very much for this great show you're giving here. I am following you, hoping that not only my eyes can see you, but also the light of the moon, the camera, so people can believe me. And well, you're doing a great job. I know you are like dancing, but you are dancing very rhythmically in the space. And well, that's the subway of New York. I am in a station in the third floor, so I am high enough to take a good picture, even if the noise of the subway, but I am not a professional photographer. I am doing it for my phone, for information to my fans in Facebook, my fans in Google Plus and in my YouTube channel, and for my pupils that I teach, all the messages that the UFOs are giving us with the great filters that Olga Bernoulli has done, and always Vivian Matt Ramirez, M. Ramirez has done also filters. I am very grateful to them both because we are collaborating together in this research that we're doing independently for love, to just to maintain the relation of the messages that we understand from all these of the UFOs. So I am taking my glasses off because I don't need them to see close. So the UFOs are here, they are moving very well. And the moon is there. They are low though, they are very low, to the right and in the center. But I see that one of the UFOs is moving in another direction. That it moves, because I see the movement, but I hope they can get closer to the moon because they are doing like a triangle there. I see three UFOs, the two red ones, no, four, and two blue. So I hope they get up toward the moon so the light, they can be seen better. Hi Andromedans, this is Charisma Pedole giving the messages that you want, that you would like humanity to know of how you're helping. Arturians also. And, well, so here I see that you're dancing beautifully, that you are in a compass of rhythm and doing geometrical now. It seems you're doing like a rectangle, two UFOs in the bottom and two UFOs up in a rect straight line towards the moon, but you are doing, the two are a little bit open, the other two are a little bit open, and I see a rectangle. So, well, you're fixing the mechanical of the forces of the energies of the moon that were fixed by a mega UFO from Andromeda. Like some weeks ago, I took the photo and the photos were filtered. So we had a lot of messages. Well, I am very grateful and doing my best. And as you know, well, today the weather in New York has been really nice. Not hot, not cold. Well, it's summer, but the wind is sometimes a little windy and cold. Well, my dear UFOs, I am getting very tired of my arm holding the camera. You don't go up. My beloved UFOs, I'm waiting some minutes and see if you can come up, if it's possible. Well, let's see, where is the moon? And where are you? You are here now. Well, the position you have is about the same, to the right. I'm going to turn the camera so we can focus you better. And so I see another UFO in the way up top, close to the moon, that is moving by itself, the red one. And here I see four blue. They are, because it's too dark, really. But the red UFOs, I see them up. I see one of them moving up. Let's get closer to the moon. Yeah, it's there. The red one, the usual one, I believe. That shiny, shiny red one. And, well, yeah, there is the red one. It just passed through the camera and is running, you see? And it goes out of my lens, so I cannot see it more. Well, that one is really dancing. The other ones are softly down. There's a red one moving, gorgeous. Well, thank you, dear Andromedan UFO. You are super, super excited tonight. Wow. Well, I don't know if it's a reflex here of a camera or something, but it's weird what I'm seeing. You're moving too much. Anyhow, when I repeat the video, I'll see what's going on. Now I see the four UFOs, the bluish ones down, the red one in the middle is moving too much. And, well, my God. This is the first time I see this spectacle like that, but, well, you always have surprises. Thank you. All the other ones are doing now a triangle, and the red UFO is like in a link to them. Well, you are giving great a show here of geometry, 60 degrees, and well, you're moving to DNA, I know, but this is very good for humanity. I am very grateful. In the name of all of those of you people that understand this work and understand the messages of how they are opening portals. Well, really, we are the ones that connect to the portal because we have a representation of one different molecular structure body in each dimension and dimension. So our bodies are there, like the aura, then the astral world, then the emotional, then the mind body, then the soul body, then the spiritual body. So they are connected in between. In each dimension and the dimension, we have a body that represents us. And the problem that humans have for the ascension is, sorry, that's the New York subway where I am taking the video. So the problem for New Yorkers, for humans, is that we don't connect from the third dimensional body in man to the other bodies that are energetic bodies of energy in fourth, fifth, sixth and dimension, then on 7, 8, and 9 dimension. They are not connecting. So if they are not connecting, we don't have a life there. So the portal is opened by our connection. And then we can do the ascension very easily. But for that, we need to have a little understanding of what's going on and how nature is built up in the warp of space-time continuum as the creation that it is of our almighty creator of one cosmos with 8 universes. We have a universe, we have galaxy, we have constellations, we have planets, we have suns. And in that, like, expecting the universal conception of objects in space and time, which we call planets, which we call suns, which we call constellations, which we call galaxies, they are built up of atomic energy, particles. So these UFOs are moving correctly, our bodies, and now I see 2 red ones and 2 blue ones in the bottom together in a pair to the right and in a pair to the left. I am able to see it even though the light is not too much. But sometimes my paranormal senses work on my superior bodies that I easily can go up. Anyhow, I'm giving the interpretation of what I'm seeing and hoping that all of you that resonate with these, they are moving our molecules, as I understand now. They are moving molecules at a molecular level now of us. And now I see another UFO, so it's 5 in total. 3 blue and 2 red in the bottom, to the bottom. Well, this is Charisma Pedole in New York saying hi, but I am getting tired standing here. and it's late. I have to work later on tomorrow in the morning, so I need to leave. My respect and gratitude for your gorgeous work, Andromedans, and perhaps Arcturians that are there. But if you are not the Arcturians, whoever you are in that orb, consciousness, intelligence, that are working and helping and guiding us, I am very grateful. Now you're doing a semicircle, a triangle, and then you move to a circle. That is gorgeous. Well, trying to get you the best, turning. Let's see what I get here, like this. And then, well, you know, that thing that runs is the Red Wolf, Andromeda. Wow, you're doing great, but you just passed like a fire in the video. And here are the other ones, the four ones in the bottom. And the moon to the bottom, you can see four UFOs. I see one that is moving, but it's very dark. Possible the red one of Andromeda, or another orb, or it's a bluish one. Now I am counting five, so I cannot tell you more, but I am counting five, I don't know. And, well, let's see when I see the video what goes on and what we see. Many blessings, Charisma from New York. Love you. Bye, good night, good morning, everybody. Hi, this is Charisma Pedole, 4 a.m. in New York. The red UFO of Andromeda is been dancing beautiful around the moon. And it's in the east, 90 degrees east. On the 27th of June. And that's the moon. And let's see, because the UFO is moving too much, if it's close to the light of the moon, so all of you can see what a beautiful work the red UFO of Andromeda is doing. I saw two UFOs, two red UFOs. But let's see if my camera can see them, can take them, because it's a very simple Android of 4 gigas. And the cars are walking here in the street, and the lights of the street are there, you can see them, but the moon is way up. Well, the night is beautiful, it's not cold, it's not warm. Let's see if the red UFO can be seen by all my fans and friends in Facebook. Well, the moon didn't come out early. It was 12:15 the last time I was checking the sky, a.m. And I just took a photo of the red UFO like 45 minutes ago, and I posted it. So let's see if now I'm lucky, because the UFO is simple there and is moving gorgeous. Hi Andromedans, this is Charisma. I'm doing my work here, helping everybody. The planet, the messages, the communication, the work each one has to do for its own self, to create its own portal, connection, to do the ascension of frequency with the planet, which you are helping so much. Well, lots of love. Charisma in New York. Love you, Andromedans. The Arcturians were here too. Well, the first time in many days I saw one of the UFOs of Arcturus that was moving very, very fast. They were leaving the spot that they were for hours. Now the red UFO is coming down. It's a little bit up, as I can see it by my phone, by the camera. And I don't know if the light of the moon would permit that you all see it. Well, Andromedans, I'm not going to stay all night, but thank you for everything you're doing for all of us inhabitants in planet Earth, hoping that each one understands and takes advantage of the great opportunity that you are giving all of us, a great opportunity of ascending. Many blessings. Charisma Pedole in New York, June 27th, 4 a.m.